Thank you. should be someone who's strong, that looks like he or she can handle the situation.
Police officers should be physically fit and not overweight.
He has to save people, and to save people, he has to be strong.
If I saw a small little guy, I'd be like, well, big deal, he's a wimpy cop.
If we're talking big cop, we're talking Sergio Oliva, Chicago Police Department.
Yeah, big guy. What's up?
Walking the other day on Pratt Boulevard, and a color fellow snatched my purse with the keys.
Do you know the fighter?
But to many, Sergio Oliva is just a cop on the beat.
You gotta have a job. I had the opportunity to join in the department. I like it because every day is something different. And I feel myself helping a lot of different people with a lot of trouble. It's been in the newspaper for many times. I know I've been helping a lot.
Sergio escaped from Castro's Cuba over 20 years ago and came to Chicago even though he was warned it was dangerous. But for the past 10 years, he's made life in Chicago a little more dangerous for criminals and is a welcome sight to any shopkeeper on his patrol.
Walks the beat here about two times a day, you know, two, three times a day. Like, as big as he is, nobody want to mess with him.
But the image of Sergio as a tough, intimidating character is one myth that Sergio would like to dispel.
You don't have to pay a macho man for any reason. I never trying to make it anybody feel inferior, which is because he's a little skinny, fat, whatever. You know, I treat him as the same. You have to come with me, you come with me. And it's up to you. You will come with me no matter what. When I say you come with me, you come with me. So it's up to you. You coming alone? No. I had to take you.
Everything come out beautiful again.
Yeah, oh, you really God. Got me scared there. Oh, my God, I'm going to get a ticket for the first time in the day.
No way, everything's come out all right.
Oh, great. Okay. Is this your beat? Is this
that's
your...
the beat, yeah, that's yeah, the yeah. station, and this is my gym.
And that's the gym. What? How convenient.
Yeah,
how convenient.
Oh, God.
I see you. What a coincidence.
Well, that's
you,
life.
You just look just as you always do, ready for competition. I
oh,
like you're in the Olympics, not yet?
No, not yet. Not ready.
Well, you never look any different. Never look any different.
Oh, God.
Yeah. What do you think about all these new blokes that are coming into
beautiful.
This new Olympics?
Beautiful.
Yeah.
They're all good. Yeah. They're all good.
Thank you. Thank you. 1984, Sergio the Myth Oliva returned briefly to the stage to compete in Mr. Olympia. The fans loved it. The judges gave him 8. The Warrior King saluted once more by his loyal tribe. It was as though he had never been away.
To regain the world's most prestigious bodybuilding trophy, Mr. Olympia, a title that was his in 1967, 68, and 69. After 14 years and at the age of 42, Sergio just might make the greatest comeback in the history of sports.
And for me, you know, I stayed away for 14 years. It was no biggie to get back. It's no big deal win or lose. I win them all, and I got nothing to lose. You know, you need the money, but it never been such a big deal to me because if it would have been for the money, I would have gone back 14 years before. I'm not rich, but I feel like $1 million.
Sergio Oliva is the myth. But Sergio Oliva, the loving family man, dedicated police officer, and proud athlete, is anything but a myth. He's known as the myth for one simple reason. Sergio Oliva defies belief. He has won nearly every bodybuilding award in the world. His influence in the sport is without parallel. He endorses products. He's featured in every bodybuilding and muscle magazine in the world. He has influenced Arnold Schwarzenegger and has been called by some experts the greatest bodybuilder who ever lived.
In the world of bodybuilding, if you've had a great body once, you can have a great body again. If you've thrilled the fans in the past, you can thrill them again. The years stand still.
A former Mr. World, a former Mr. Universe, a three-time Mr. Olympia,
a baby boy, perhaps the next Met. Now, you should give it the applause and cooperate whoever's the winner, because that's what we came here tonight. Give it the support to the best man. The place that I took tonight, it doesn't matter, 8, 9, 1, 17, 20, no matter what, I will be forever the myth. There, the Olympia was different, you know. When I went to the American without even compete, because they were afraid to come to the stage and they gave me all the trophy because they don't want to compete.
Sergio Oliva was so far ahead of his time in at least one competition, the others didn't bother turning up. The only man to outmuscle Arnold Schwarzenegger, Oliva used bodybuilding as his ticket out of Cuba. The symbols of his success surround him, but for Oliva, it was all trophies and no money. Where once the sport helped him escape to the States, today it's the chance to make another comeback.
I wanted to escape, but number one in the boat, it was too risky. Too many shots. I scared of it. See, for me, shots, you can't fight. If you throw them a punch, you're going to eat my arms. If you're trying to kick it, they're going to eat my leg. And if you're trying to swim, and nobody swims faster than the shark, right? So you're dead anyway, you know? So I said, got to be a better way. That's when I started practicing all the sport. I tried the boxing, the running, the wrestling. I try every time I play baseball. But those guys in Cuba, they're mean. No break. The only break I got, it was through the weight. That's when I became a weight.
Sergio, when he was at his peak, he was unbelievable. I remember one day we met in Chicago, and I invited him to a very sophisticated restaurant, and he had to wear a shirt and a tie. And sure enough, Sergio came in with tank top, and with his medals in front of him, and I thought it was going to throw all of us out, but not Sergio. And they looked at him. The maitre d' didn't say a word. The place was quiet. They just stared and stared at him. He was absolutely the most wonderful, fabulous sight you can imagine when he was in shape. And even now, I won't dare talk with him at all.
Say something, Arnold.
I think.
Thank you. I won't say much. Joe already said it all. I thank you for being here, appreciate it. God bless her all. Here's Arnold.
Joe Weider and his champions. You'll never get this picture again. Thank you, gentlemen.
Have you ever felt?
Are you listening? Damn.
be forever the myth. Right.